Welcome to Gaming with Scott presents Marvel Superheroes. Join us each week as our intrepid heroes follow a path of adventure and attempt to save the world and each other from the dangers of the universe. Starring Martin Davis, Josh Elliott, John Garlick, Josh Jackson, and Rico Suarez, with me, Scott Troiano, running the table as the judge. Epic adventure and titanic struggles await you beyond this music.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to Gaming with Scott. I am here with Josh.
Caesar 1 is useless.
Oh, and Rico.
Yo.
Marty.
Huh?
John.
Whatever, Caesar 1's awesome.
And Josh.
I think they're both idiots.
You can fly yourself places.
Oh. All right, the Phantom Zone has swathed you over as you two reach over to high five. Are you actually going to high five?
Why not? Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, duh.
As their hands touch, light and dark meet, there is a thunderclap within the Phantom Zone. Their bodies merge and meld. How would you describe the outcoming response?
You ever seen altered states?
Innuendo.
All right.
We talked a little bit about
this. I imagine that we're like 9 feet tall.
Yep.
Is this a sex thing? We are Dark Force energy.
Yeah, it's a sex joke.
We have two sets of wings. One of the set are his leathery demon-like wings. The second set are my feathery angel-like wings. We have a long, slender body.
Must work out.
Yeah. slithering type fork tail.
Our kegels are off the chain.
Wow.
We have four arms. Out of our heads come these huge, giant... have you guys seen
Legs?
Legend?
Yeah.
How, you know, the devil there has the horns that come out and then go up. Ours come out and go up and swoop back.
Tim Curry.
Like that. Yeah. Holding in our hands, we have this big, long 12-foot scythe. And then we have this big, long, gaping maw.
Basically, give the thing from Legend a scythe. And an extra set of wings, and we're good to go.
Sounds terrifying.
But it had 10 And when we talk, there's the echo of both of our voices talking at the same time.
So do you only have one head?
Yeah, we only have one head.
Where's the other one?
Well, I mean...
And we go by the name the Shadowed Seraphim.
Which, in this context, really, really works. It is angelic and demonic at the same time.
It does. And it's funny.
It is truly a frightful beast to behold. There, when you look at it and it stands still, you hear almost the choir of angels in the back of your head and the wails of the damned.
Oh, and don't forget the big palm print we have.
Right. I mean, we are, in essence, what would happen if the Republican Party embraced domestic spending.
Ooh. Yeah.
So what you're saying is I have a quivering erection.
maybe a little bit.
Marty's still making it weird. Little,
yeah. And Marty makes it creepy.
So yeah, that's what stands before you guys and the one Kryptonian knight that got sucked into the Phantom Zone with us.
As long as you have a cod piece, we're good.
Thank you.
And, I think that we would immediately look over to the Kryptonian with
murderous intent?
Murderous intent.
Murderous intent.
Terrible, dripping, dark force energy dripping out of our maw and sizzling as it lands on whatever debris is in here.
Although technically that was our action, was to...
Yeah.
So...
Was to go through that entire Sailor Moon animated cycle.
Sounds more like Dragon Ball Z to me.
Okay, yes.
Like fusion dance.
Yeah.
It's okay. It's okay. Your armor's pretty. It's okay.
Oh, yeah, it's pretty.
It is.
And it has awakened. You feel almost as though the landscape itself has tremored in response to this creation.
To them?
Yes.
Yeah.
All right.
Tell the Fenrir to subdue the knight.
I'm going to look at that thing. Ah!
Okay.
Absolutely no response.
Just oh, God!
Oh, you've seen this before.
No, he hasn't.
I've not seen this before. I've seen terrible things, but I have no idea what any... That is cool, but I'm in the negative zone. That's having more of an impact on me than how someone works.
Okay.
I noticed that things changed when they did that.
So what do we see around
us? What's that guy doing
at
night?
Okay. Dark, barren rock in all directions as far as the eye can see. You cannot make out a horizon. There are no stars in the sky. There does not seem to be a sky. It is the opposite of what you would think being in a terrestrial on a planet would be like. It is almost like, if you would think about it, the atmosphere is the land and there is nothing else. You are breathing, but you don't feel air move in and out while you do. It seems it's weird as all get out. It is an experience the likes of which none of you have ever experienced. Even in your other place, it seemed natural. Whereas this seems completely and utterly artificial.
Is the stuff around me, is it organic?
How would you know?
Would I be able to...
We'll try it.
Mind if I could.
Is that what you're going to do this turn?
Sure, I'll do that.
What is the Gestalt doing this turn? What is the Shadowed Seraphim doing this turn?
We're going to grab the Kryptonium and bite its head off.
Is that what we're doing?
Is that what we're doing?
But what if he's the only one that can get us out of here?
We have to agree. If we don't agree, then interesting things happen.
Oh. I'm just saying, what if he's the only one that can get us out of this place?
I think we should rip him in half and wear him on our hand like a puppet.
I think we just lost our action because we're about to have a conversation.
Correct.
You want to do the puppet?
Subdue the knight.
Yeah.
Okay.
I
mean, it was just a peon.
Run from my demon might be our way out.
Fair enough.
Well, I'm going to...
Yeah, I think so.
Okay, so your crowd is going to subdue the knight.
Because I'm thinking he might be the only one who knows how to get us out of this space.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to assist him.
You might be right, though.
I'm going to terminate the...
If we're not right,
then we'll eat probability manipulation
drink his blood.
The Gestalt.
Okay.
We've reached a decision.
Okay, hold that thought. You're trying to move rocks with your mind?
Yeah, I'm just trying to move stuff around.
Okay. Let's roll initiative. Rico cannot roll for the group this time.
Give me a 51.
I'll roll. Right. Why? Are you just mad? Yes.
Did you just roll? No. No. You guys are having a conversation. Yeah. You're jumping in.
I should never roll. I rolled a 1.
You rolled a 1.
What's your modifier? Plus 5.
But a 1 is always 16, a 1.
A 1's a 1.
So we rolled a 3.
You're still 51. I'm still boosting you up.
So it's
Kryptonian makes to his feet and lights to the air.
Yellow.
Oh, no. So okay. He's out?
Nothing.
No.
None of this is organic.
No.
Oh, okay.
So he's out, he's gone?
Well, he's hovering 10 feet in the air.
Gotcha. Okay.
That's relative.
Well, it is relative. 10 feet away from where you were. Alright, hold on.
They're coming to take me away?
A whole 10 feet?
Yeah.
Neat.
Neat.
We're 9 feet tall. We could reach up. Half reach up and pluck him down.
Okay. Nothing?
I was assisting Josh.
So soliloquy?
Yes?
Subdue him. He might know how to get us out.
And that's when whirlwinds erupt around you and they jump all over him. Give me a roll.
89.
Sorry. Okay. Four or five of them.
98 of his stuff's still on.
Five of them dogpile the guy and begin dragging him down to the ground.
Okay.
Five
Fenrir.
The Fenrir.
All right. Declaring for next round, Josh.
Hold on. I don't know.
I am...
John?
Okay, I am going to... okay, so is he very thoroughly...
He's dogpiled.
Okay. By Dogman.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Okay, I'm going to a wolf man, excuse me.
Oh, sorry, he's wolf piled.
Yes.
My apologies.
Tell it to your
I don't mean to be racist.
I'm just holding right now.
Okay, I am going to, I'm going to move over to where the, Kryptonian is and try to drag him to the ground.
Okay.
I mean, to the surface.
Okay, Tomahawk?
I'm going to reach out as far as I can using communication with cybernetics to see if anybody or anything in here, as far as I can see or feel, if there's anyone here, and if they have cybernetics.
Okay. And what is the Shadowed Seraphim doing?
We're probably going to grab him with two of our hands to subdue him and prevent him from going anywhere.
Okay, so you're going to assist with the subduing?
Yeah.
Okay.
Does that sound good? Sounds good, right?
Yeah.
All right, who's rolling initiative?
Not me.
should I roll?
Yes.
11.
So you did your modifier of plus 8?
Oh, no.
Plus 8?
We just 13. Did plus 6, then we got a 13.
Nice.
You guys get to go first.
Of course.
Hooray.
So yeah, we're going to take two of our hands and wrap around him.
Okay.
Firm.
You've got him.
Hold.
You put one foot on him. He is held.
Sure.
Hold.
He's holding. Give me a roll.
Is this count as a 10 or is it a 0?
It's a 0. Okay. A 0 is a 0 on the singles die. That's a 7.
7 on a 50 yellow.
Okay. Yes. That way. Way over that way. Like, right at the edge of your communication range.
Is it like a person or is it like a...
It's a person.
I have contact with something out there, a cyber something out there.
The Kryptonian yells, "Release me!"
No.
Next question.
I want to get right face to face with him.
Oh, smooch.
Make out.
And let him, and say, as our voice echoes, both of our voices echo to him, "You're our ticket out of here. And if you don't get us out of here,
you're our meal ticket."
Sure.
I will gladly give my life for those that would kill the son of Jor-El.
Okay.
We're not going to kill him, though. We can just torture him.
Be accommodating. Yeah, right this now. Guy.
He's not going to talk.
Doesn't sound like it.
They're all kind of culty.
It would be great if somebody had mind control stuff.
That would be fantastic.
Okay.
Well, but they have given no... They said, you're our meal. You're our ticket out of here. They haven't necessarily said they're going to do anything.
No,
they haven't made any moves for the killie yet.
I wasn't going to mind control them.
Oh, okay.
I wasn't saying for him to do that.
No, I could mind control him.
Oh, you're a
mind control
dog.
Yeah. I was saying the... Never
mind. Snaps.
That's what I meant by that. Yeah. Anyway.
All right. Okay, well, I'm going to lock eyes with the Kryptonian. And say, listen, we need to, we have important business on Earth. We need to return to our home world.
And you will return.
That'll convince him.
You will return to the home, to your home world when your punishment has been fulfilled.
How long are we supposed to stay here? In our time.
1 year and one day.
No.
That's not as bad as I thought.
That's not too bad.
I have to admit. I mean, screw it, we're not doing it.
Out of character, I think I have a couple of demonic things that are pending in that time, so...
It could be! I've got a couple contracts with demons that are going to be up before that. That doesn't work for me.
Yeah.
That's what I just heard.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, well, you know.
Yeah, whatever.
Well, you know. Actually, no, that's when the banishment ends.
That's
what I'm thinking of.
On the bank manager.
Hey, here's another idea. I can just keep duplicating him until we find one that's amenable to helping us. I was being totally sincere.
Dude. Copy and of a copy of a copy. Eventually, there's going to be Kryptonians on the thing.
If none of them are, then yes, we will happily eat them.
I will help.
I see this as a win-win.
Why is that Kryptonian drooling on us? Oh, is that number 7?
Come on, Corky. All
right.
Steve. Steve the Kryptonian.
Steve the Quick.
What is your name, Kryptonian?
Name it Steve.
I am one of the judges.
Okay, judge. About to be one of the just desserts.
I'm seriously about to bite this dude.
Let me make another one first.
You must return us to Earth, or I will force you to.
I would like to see you try.
Our right hand is really on.
Do it! I'm going to try to mind control him. I am aware of the consequences of mind control.
Yay!
I hate it. 62. Okay. 62 on mind control. Amazing.
That's a yellow, bro.
That's a yellow.
Can't even make it go away when I push it. Okay.
Yellow.
And Caesar looks down at him and locks eyes with him, and you notice two of the tattoos on the side of his neck flare, and the Kryptonian tries to look away but cannot.
We got his attention.
Tell me what this place is, and how do we leave?
This is the Phantom Zone. None have escaped. Okay, a few have escaped. And he says that afterwards when he's like, and he's obviously fighting with himself. Mm-hmm.
Okay, if you escaped.
Who's escaped?
So how'd they escape?
Doomsday?
Oh.
A couple at least.
While he's talking,
all right.
I'm going to fly out towards...
Okay, Tomahawk takes off. Just...
Where the hell is he going? Where I was going. You're going to see another prison?
This is one word.
How do they leave? How are prisoners removed from this place?
When he's obviously struggling not to answer you. Mm-hmm. When your sentence expires, you are freed automatically. The escapes, 3 have escaped by detonating a large enough explosion in close enough proximity to the outside of the zone to fracture it. Two have known to escape from inside. They had to bargain with the Dread.
George.
What is the Dread?
You don't want to know. It is an evil that has been locked within the Phantom Zone since its creation. It was why we built this place originally. Its sentence is eternity.
Well, I say we give the Kryptonian to the Dread and use that as our ticket out.
I'm okay with that.
That's what we think.
Can you get us out of here? All of us?
You feel his will rail against your own. Mm-hmm. Roll again.
Okay.
He was jetting up somewhere.
56.
Okay. He struggles, it thrashes for a bit, and says, "No. I am as trapped as you are."
Hunger?
Tom? No. We need him to give him to the Dread. Mm. We're not giving anyone to the Dread. That's evil.
We don't know. Well, it is evil, yeah. From what he said.
Don't make sacrifices to powers you don't. Yeah, you can't control. That is...
We don't need to control it. It's stuck here in the Phantom Zone. If it can get us out, then it can get us out.
So where is this thing? Is that where Tomahawk jetted off to?
I don't know. That's a good question.
We can find Tomahawk. Tomahawk is findable. He's a good guy.
Tomahawk always sends him a flare.
We need to get him one of those teddy bear
bowls. Whatever. We always go, oh my god, what's going on over there? Oh, Tomahawk. Yeah, got it.
Okay. These things happen.
They do.
The Dread.
Well, then let's go find Tomahawk and take the Kryptonian with us.
We intend to leave here.
good luck.
You may come with us if you would rather not be stranded here for eternity.
Are you offering to aid me?
Yes.
Why would you do that when you're obviously enemies of Krypton?
Because there are circumstances regarding the fate of Superman, the son of Jor-El, that we did not have time to elucidate at our trial.
What he's saying is we are not enemies to Krypton. We do not view you as enemies. And with that...
Well, what enemies of Jor-El and Kal-El do you speak of? What things did you not have time to properly sort out?
We were attempting to heal Superman.
We were ignorant to what we were doing, and we know that now. Hindsight is 20/20. Yes, we took part in it, but it was not something we wished to do. We're trying to make recompense for doing that, I guess.
And your time spent here will be that recompense, and then your records will be clean.
Nothing was more important to Superman than the well-being of Earth. If we are banished from Earth for a year and a day, then terrible things will happen and render all of his work for naught.
Many will die if we are absent that long. We cannot stay.
Why will they die?
Because we are the protectors of that place now with Superman not being there.
And you will all take this charge?
I will. I'll let everyone else speak for themselves.
What? I wasn't even paying... What?
Do we want
to
take charge?
And the shadowed seraphim talks to itself for a moment, literally goes, yeah, we can do that. What? I wasn't paying attention. Huh? What are we doing? Yeah, we can do that, right? And literally, like, has this conversation with its... You can see the face meld between the angelic and the demonic.
So much crazy going on. It's like Transformers the movie over here.
Yeah. He asked if we would take up the mantle of Superman and defending the Earth since he's no longer there.
Yeah, then you can get that cape you want.
That's true.
Yeah, whatever. Okay.
We agree.
He's like, yeah, whatever. I don't want the key.
Tomahawk would...
Fenris, give me an intuition roll. You need a red feat.
I'm going to spend
karma. He is still boosted from...
You are still probability manipulated. Yes. Just give me a roll. Okay. You want to spend karma?
If I need a red feat, yes.
Oh, okay.
I might not even do it. Too late now. You've already said it.
Never know.
50. So 50.
Yeah.
Better than an 05.
Yeah.
You suck.
All right, what's your intuition?
75.
Well, that's a great buddy.
Intuition 75.
365.
Okay. The you notice as
we should split now.
Caesar one, his eyes are locked and Tomahawk is gone.
Okay.
You notice that the soil around the feet of the shadowed seraphim is literally decaying. It is
splitting,
becoming
necrotic. Remember how you ungestalt? Remember how I talked to you about ungestalting? We're going to do that.
Sorry.
Okay.
Good.
So say that again.
There's poop noises going on.
We're going to split.
Give me a roll to activate your power.
25?
52?
No,
25.
Off. Oh, I thought
the 90. 90, solid?
Solid 90, 9-0.
Okay.
Boom.
Not a probability manipulated 90.
No, it's 9-0-0.
Oh, are you?
9 on the 10s.
I cut you off when you turned into a demon.
Just when he went mega form, he was like,
just to be on the safe side.
Yes,
because he didn't know if you were going to flip out and eat everyone in the party, which might have happened.
Which might have happened.
Maybe.
Who else is at the party?
If we can't ungestalt, there's a very good possibility we're going to eat everybody.
Okay.
We don't know how long we have control in this form.
On Unearthly, it was a 25. Is that a green feat on Unearthly?
Why, yes. Yes, it is.
Okay. The two of them split and come out as Tyler Freeborn and Dr. Wells, not their gestalted forms. There is a crack of almost an inverse... A bolt of lightning leaps from their horns, channels into one, and leaps out into the nothing. And whoosh, there are two people standing there, somewhat dazed. You both feel like you just got a ride on the vomit comet. and you guys feel spent. You're just like, oh god, I'm gonna puke.
So I have an observation. When you guys were yin and yang, like all the soil underneath your feet was decaying away. So the space around you was deteriorating away.
Oh my god, we're too awesome for the universe as we know it. Oh my god.
I don't know what the hell that means.
I'm going to,
I just saw it.
Oh, it's good stuff.
Magic detection. Just to, you know, it's the first time I've done it here.
So yep.
I'm going to point it generally at them.
I'm
going to
just
to detect what's going on.
Can I recline and float? Because I feel like I want to recline and just float, right?
Yeah, hold that thought.
Let's see. It is a crummy... 41, yes. It is just barely a green.
Okay. This is when it hits you that this is a completely synthetic environment.
Okay.
There is no magic. I mean, like, none.
There's
like wisps that came off of them a bit, but you're kind of used to that at this point.
Right.
There's like the sort none. There's no in the sky. There's normally some sort of celestial planets aligned kind of stuff that happens that you're like, oh yes, it is the forces of the universe and the ley lines of power that run through the entire cosmos. There's none of that.
Okay.
And more to the point, your attention is now drawn to semi-crater between where those two were standing. It's almost like you feel that area. It's 3 feet, 4 feet wide.
Uh-huh.
And had started to bow a little bit. But you feel that area, and it's already starting to recover slightly, like the color is changing back to more normalish land for where you are.
Dark gray.
But yes, but you feel it like sucking at like, oh, magic? Delicious. Feed us. And you feel that they're like, whoa. So it's almost like anti-magic. I mean, it's the kind of thing, like, you don't want to go anywhere near that.
Okay. They were drawing in cosmic energy that isn't available here.
Yes.
Okay. Alright, I'm going to turn to the,
cool.
I'm going to turn to the Kryptonian. Bringing these two here was a mistake. I think they are going to compromise the integrity of this phantom zone of yours.
Impossible. It cannot be done.
I'll point at the hole that they just generated.
Tilt his head up to see.
Okay, and he looks over, he goes, it's getting better.
Just a flesh wound.
It cannot be done from within the zone itself. It is impregnable. It is an inescapable fortress from which only two have escaped, and we're not sure how that happened.
He just double dog dared you.
I'm way too tired right now.
You.
I will,
be a warrior.
I will, release him. Release him from his mind control.
Okay. And he kind of shakes his head. What have you done to me? Get out of my mind, you vile wretch.
We probed you. Next time we'll use the holes.
Next time we'll eat you.
Please
do not eat. I really have a problem.
Are you going to do the thing?
Do we need this guy? Need this guy? What's going on?
We got to find Dredd or do what you did again and blow this pop stand.
We agreed to take on the defense of Earth in the name of Superman.
We did, and he still said sort of screw you.
Well, he said get out of my mind, vile wretch.
Oh, well, he's out of your mind. Are we good now? Are we cool?
You will then take on the mantle?
Yeah.
Of the protection?
Yeah.
Of your planet?
Yeah.
Yes.
Well, everybody's got to speak.
As long as we live, and possibly then some.
Oh, yeah, dude. It's cool. Thumbs up. Oh, I'm just going to chill here in the Phantom Zone and relax.
Okay, you lean back. Give me your Gestalt power. Give me a Gestalt power roll.
Oh, okay. 17? Are we still probability controlled?
No, I cut you off when you turned into
17. That's a white.
Okay. You go to lean back and you realize you're not going to float. And you see Tyler Freeborn go, yeah, I'm okay.
Ooh.
<I'm here>.
Yeah.
he thought you were going to stop. Oh, God.
They look visibly worse for wear, even though Tyler's like shaking it off much better than Dr. Wells. He's just like,
awkward. Oh, that was new.
Whatever. I can handle it. I can hang.
I think that. So your power touches the divine.
Oh, yeah, yeah, I said that ate forever ago.
I feel like I just ate a bucket of rotten avocado.
So, his power touches the rotten avocado. That this brings it in, brings things that are entirely foreign to this place, which was built without any understanding of magic or spirits.
So what are you saying?
Or aesthetics, for that matter.
Could we, like, break out? Is that what you're saying? Is that what you're suggesting?
I believe that there is that...
Occultist?
Oh,
Roll it.
No.
Plus two column shifts?
I'm so wiped right now.
Be a man!
71?
No, I'm sorry.
74.
74?
On two column shifts. I don't know.
There are places that are purely wild magic where the mundane will destroy them. Okay, okay. Where technology will just, you know, the pure and untouched areas of the wild wilds, where even, you know, forged iron and technology will literally cause the degradation of the static reality.
And this place, though, is like
the reverse
of that.
Or this would be very similar to the reverse of that.
You should do it again and do it harder. Rock out.
I literally start singing, I go, I believe I can fly. I believe we can crack the sky. I'm telling you, man, Kryptonians are gay.
We don't even have Tomahawk with us.
We better assemble our party.
Oh, God, where the hell is Tomahawk?
Hey, do the comms still work? Probably not.
Nope.
Okay, never mind.
You must assemble your party before venturing forth.
We gotta find Tomahawk.
I just didn't know if the comms worked at all.
All right, you guys go find Tomahawk. I'm going to rest here on this rock.
All right.
Do you really think we should...
No, I mean, I can't fly, so...
I mean,
you're nauseous, dude. It's not splitting the...
We'll help you.
Okay.
You don't want to start feeling better. You don't want to be prison molested by whoever was put here by...
Judge Dredd.
By Judgy McJudge... judging here.
That is super scary.
I was talking to the guy.
Let's do it.
When we find Tomahawk, then we'll do that thing.
Okay.
Cool.
I don't know if we can even gestalt in here.
What way did he go? That way?
That way.
Yeah.
All right. That way!
You think we could? Yeah. We'll try when we get back.
I'm
going to
be conserving my magic while I'm here.
Okay.
I'm going to let down the, let the probability manipulation fall.
Okay.
And I'm going to turn off my armor.
Okay.
And I'm going to just conserve my energies.
Okay. When you turn off the armor, you drop the probability manipulation, the wings of the eagle. You're like, you feel a little better.
Okay.
You hadn't noticed previously that running at your standard, this place...
It was like, being the high pressure thing into the low pressure environment.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Reverse osmosis.
Understood.
Reverse osmosis. It makes so much sense.
we passed a specific heat boundary.
Alright.
Yeah.
So how do we get to Tomahawk? I can't fly.
We're going
it flies awfully fast.
Does this place have wind? If we're down, wind will know.
You're saying Tomahawk smells.
Well, let's cut over to Tomahawk and see what he's up to.
You are blazing across the landscape. You are not dallying, I take it. You are just... And there's one click, two clicks, three clicks, four clicks, 20 clicks, 50 clicks.
Because you have flight at what, 100?
75.
75. Okay, that's still...
That's still
like hundreds of miles an hour.
That's pretty monstrous!
Yep. And he is just... You bolt, and you come up to... You see a shape on the horizon. It seems to be rectangular. It's not angular like the rocks that you've been passing previously.
Okay.
It's coming up relatively quickly.
I want to slow down so I don't run into it.
Well, obviously.
Yeah.
But are you going to just fly right up to it?
I mean, what?
It appears to be a group of buildings.
Okay.
Houses? I don't know.
Okay. From afar, you're saying...
Yes.
Okay. I'm gonna fly up to it.
Okay. There are four nearly square, 12 feet tall square objects buildings. Square by 12 by 12 by 12.
How many are there?
Four of them.
Four. Are they like one, two?
They're cubic squares, bro. Come on.
They're in a square as well?
They're in a square as well, yes.
I'm going to touch it.
It's the same rock that you're standing on.
I want to walk around.
There's a door on the inside. The door of one faces the blank wall of another. That door faces the other one. That door faces this one. So they face their door. So the one that you find the side with a door, and you notice that the opposite corner has a door facing the opposite direction. So if you came out of the door, you'd hit one. To hit one, you'd hit one. You'd hit one. If you went out of all of the doors, does that make sense?
Is it actual doors or
it's a door?
Just archway?
It's a there's a, like a door and a doorknob.
Okay, well, this is some Nightmare Before Christmas stuff. I'm gonna open the Christmas door.
Okay,
you should always knock first, man.
Okay, you try the door. You try the door. It appears locked.
I'm gonna try the rest of it.
Okay, they all appear locked.
Okay, I knock on them.
The door opens. There is a female standing in the doorway. She is dark-skinned, hairless, with slits for eyes. She looks to be somewhat reptilian. What?
Do you want to get out of here?
There is no escape from here.
Okay. Who are you?
I am Leisha.
Leisha. Tomahawk. I don't know if that matters to you. But I'm just trying to get my bearings.
You are in Kelnor.
Kelnor.
What is that? That is our group name.
They have geography in this place.
Who's the group?
I am Leisha. There are four others that live here.
Oh, are these are all homes?
Yes.
Oh.
It took you so long to discern that.
It could be.
He's a crazy skeleton guy. He doesn't know what
it could be. All sorts
of
things.
It could have been a much
skeleton. You guys
assume there are four buildings with doors. Oh, these are houses?
They don't look like houses.
It could have been other stuff.
He's in an alien landscape. That's.
So.
You're the best, Tom.
What are you doing?
I rolled a one. I rolled Marty's reason.
What do you do here? As a group.
We are living out our sentence.
How long is your sentence?
That's rather rude to ask.
Is it? I don't know.
Are you not a prisoner?
They put us here for something he said we were judged. And
yes, you were judged as guilty, and you are serving your sentence. Therefore, you are a prisoner, correct?
No, I'm a hostage. I've been taken.
Yeah.
Because...
Yes, if you give it enough time, we all come to grips with the fact that, guilty or not, we are here. Some of us hostages, some of us prisoners, some of us...
I wasn't guilty for anything. I didn't do anything. I wasn't guilty at all.
And many of us said that when we first came here.
What if we can get you out?
Damn. You don't even know what she did.
There is no... There is no escape from this prison.
Not with that attitude, there is it.
That's what I'm thinking.
Well, you steal my words.
So you're continuing.
And why would you offer to help me escape from my term of imprisonment?
Well, because this prison is obviously flawed.
How is that obvious?
Oh, are you guilty? What'd you do to get in here?
Yes, I am guilty.
What'd you do to get in here?
I killed a guy who knocked on my door.
That would have been a good answer. Time out, pause.
I killed someone for asking too many questions.
Mormon missionary, if you must know.
I killed a number of people.
Okay. Was it self-defense?
No.
No, you did it on purpose?
Not exactly on purpose.
Well, did you mean to kill them? You're like, great, it'd be great to kill some people, right? And you killed them?
Not particularly.
Well, then you regret it.
What is your point?
My point is, I didn't do anything, and I am here. I didn't do anything. So obviously, I know this whole justice system of what they call justice is flawed. Inherently flawed. So you may be in a flawed system, judged harshly and unfairly. That's why I'd like to get you out. Maybe you can get a fair trial and account for being here for, I don't know how long you've been here. Maybe that'll be taken into account. So my offer was, if we can find a way out, will you help us?
I would love to leave this place. If you can make that happen, please let me know.
Well, I have one of the justices here.
What do you mean, a justice?
A judge.
There's a judge here.
Yeah.
Oh! She closes the door. She's like, eek! You hear it lock.
I'm going to go knock on the other door.
The door cracks open. Yes?
Hey, you went out.
Who are you?
Dumb mom. Who are you?
That's not important.
Okay.
Why are you here?
A judge doesn't understand real justice.
None of them do.
Alright, well then we agree. Let's get out of here.
I love his logic. It's awesome.
There is no way out of here.
Well, if we could find a way out, are you interested in helping?
Certainly, if you find a way, let me know. And he All closes right. the door.
I'm going to go to the third one.
Okay. The door opens.
Is that a baby Goldilocks? Let's do this.
You see what looks to be 4 or 5 feet into the room.
Hey, if there's
the room is like 4 by 4.
Yes.
It appears empty. You hear a voice from within. What?
I walk in.
Door open.
Okay.
Walk in, really. Kind of Spartan. Yeah, where are you? So I can talk to you.
Right in front of you.
I don't see you.
And you saw what happened to the guy who yapped too much in front of their well.
Yeah. You can see me.
Okay, where?
I'm in the room.
All right, you let me know when I'm looking in the right direction. Say when.
When?
Up or down?
Yes.
Oh, are you invisible?
No.
Are you like a gas?
Are you stupid?
Let me check.
Are you a gas? Are you stupid?
Psyche? Is that psyche?
No, yeah. It's your reason.
Yeah, reason.
It's 14. A 1, I told
you. Oh, 40. Well, it's incredible, so. No.
Okay.
I'm not stupid.
You're in a 4x4 room. The cube is 12x12.
I don't know how big it is inside.
Right? Okay. Just, you were like, huh, smaller on the inside. That's weird.
It's very thick walls.
Okay, so what you're saying is, I'm inside something.
Well, you're inside the 12x12.
Yeah. So, okay, I'm going to step out, like, can I see you now? I'm going to look out away from the door.
No, you're not looking.
And I'm looking at you now. So what are you, a room? Are you a super room? That is the dumbest power. I'm going to shut the door. I'm going to go knock on the floor.
What you say?
That's racist against locations.
That's awesome.
Okay.
So
that's spacist.
That is spacist. That is little jerks.
Little
jerks.
Get off my lawn.
You're the wrong kind of noun. I only talk to... places and things. No, I'm sorry. People and things.
He knocked on someone's doors, mind their own business, walked in their room, talked shit about their fundamental identity. They got indignant with them and walked out.
Well,
so somebody has a what the hell story.
Right?
God damn it. They better learn how to present themselves. Knock on the door. Answer the door. Hello? Who are you? Where are you?
Go to the fourth house.
Yeah, I'm going to knock on the fourth house.
Okay.
Is it made of bricks?
No. Door opens. You're standing in the doorway at about 1 foot, 9 inches, is a small lizard in scrappy clothes.
Does this have the cybernetics I've been looking for?
Yes.
Okay.
And you can tell because one arm is metal.
Nice.
And he's, yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Who the hell are you? I could sense you across the void, so I came here to see who you are. There was nothing where I was, so I came to you. Who are you?
It just kills me. You bitch about my ethics. He's walking around Alcatraz trying to make friends and shit. You don't say a word. You sit there playing with your
He's funny because he has no ethics, and that's lovely.
Hey, I've never stopped ethics. You from doing anything you wanted to do.
Okay. Your ethics are whatever is good for you.
I have to give you that. You just crushed my soul.
It was messed up when I found it.
I am. Wow.
I was crushed when I got there.
I am Morat.
Burn. Morat?
Nightbird. Yes.
Morat. Morat?
No, Morat.
I'm Tomahawk. I put on my hand to shake hands. I don't want to, assume you can't shake hands. I'm just going to do that. No, shake hands.
Isn't he, 1 foot 9 inches
tall? Hey! I'm not going to make any assumptions on
it. He reaches up with two fingers on a three-fingered hand, puts his two fingers together, and touches the tips of his fingers to the tips of yours.
E.T. moments!
You touch tips.
Sorry, it was only your first time. You got two.
So, I am rather confused.
You are in a prison. What is your confusing? You were sentenced as guilty and sent here. You're in a prison.
Yeah, I didn't do anything. Literally, I'm not...
Yes, none of us did. I understand that.
No, literally, I wasn't even there when the crime took place. I wasn't even
talking smack to the judge.
But apparently, I'm guilty for doing something I didn't do. That seems rather unjust. And it seems like a flawed prison.
Okay.
So I'm supposed to be here a year and a day.
Oh, a light sentence.
What's your sentence? You don't mind my asking.
I do.
Mind your own business. You do know that telling people that, oh, I'm about to get out of here, guys, is a good way to get your butt kicked in prison.
Whatever happens.
He's got natural armor and super strength. None of these guys are a challenge to him.
This thing's going to be like a god. It's just going to kill all of us.
I am sentenced here for another 42 years.
Wow.
Of your time.
What?
You are a Terran, correct?
Earth?
Yes. That's what you call it.
Yes, then yes.
Yes.
Where are you from?
Oh, well, elsewhere.
Is that a planet?
No.
Is it a universe?
The closest planet that you... Well, the closest area that you would know would be a floating conglomeration, or let's put it this way, the last place I was an installation... called Nowhere.
Oh. That narrows it down.
Precisely.
I don't know where Nowhere is.
I know you don't. That's okay.
Alright.
He seems to think you should know where it is. He's like, Nowhere.
I have no idea even what that is.
Right.
So, alright, well, I'll assume you said something that makes sense to me. Were you guilty?
Yes.
What was your crime?
The destruction of a civilization.
Oh, really? So, what civilization did you destroy?
Is that pertinent to your not guilt?
None of this is pertinent.
I really hope it was Krypton.
That's why I was just trying to be friends.
The civilization that I destroyed was a relatively small civilization. There were only a couple of hundred billion.
That's small?
Well, compared to something like the Arcanide Empire, yes.
Oh, those guys?
Those guys.
So?
I've had crossings with those guys.
Who hasn't?
What's your take on them?
They're the Arcanides.
Great. What's your personal take on them?
I'd personally like to destroy their civilization.
All right.
He likes
and we're in a court.
He has a thing.
Okay, so...
But I could be biased. It's sort of a hobby.
All right.
I like this Ijuana.
Do you bear malice to all civilizations?
No. Just those that are inferior to me. And my civilization.
Okay, well... The point I'm trying to get to is... If somehow I had a way out of here, and I might be able to bring a, you know, a plus one, what I'm trying to say
it's
is
the prom.
That if you can help me get rid of the Arcanines and spare our civilization, then I think that'd be a deal.
I don't know. We'll talk about and would there be a way to do so in such a fashion as not being caught? I don't want to come back.
Well, if we can get out of here once, we can get out of here again. Make a deal, right?
Well, yes, I imagine you are correct. If we can get out of here once, we can get out of here repeatedly. So how do we get out of here?
I'll leave that up to the rest of my team. They're this.
You have a team?
I do. You want to come meet them?
Your team is guilty of the same crime that you are innocent of?
Apparently we're all guilty of this crime that we aren't guilty of, but he's a lunatic judge and put us in here anyway.
Well, of course, they all are.
All right, well, would you like to meet them?
I guess.
Or right, hop on.
Hop on what?
Are you letting him mount you?
I'm letting him jump on my shoulder.
This is getting weird.
What's the karma loss for bargaining genocide?
Until
just curious.
Until one side, it's just big talk.
Right.
Okay.
You want me to do what?
Jump on my shoulder. Is that bad? Am I not supposed to do that?
He jumps like 6 inches.
Boop.
1 foot on the door frame, kicks off the door frame. Hops twice on your shoulder and lands back in his doorframe. He goes, "That was something I have not done before.
Yeah,
thank
cool.
you
you're
for the invitation.
To, you're supposed literally. To hang out on the shoulder while
just
I fly. You.
Shoulder.
Can you fly?
Why would I fly?
To get places.
Where's that again?
Okay, my team.
You
is
can easy. Fly?
I'm flying right now.
Well, I thought you had walked to the door. Why would I walk? Why would I walk when I can hover like an omnipotent being? I see. Strike fear in the hearts of men. I get it.
Or you know, whatever.
Or lizards, right? And he goes, "Oh, so you wish to provide me transportation?"
You are his mount.
Excellent. And he jump kicks and lands on your shoulder and wraps his cybernetic arm around your neck.
Neat.
Wait, the entire arm? Neat.
Yes.
The little tiny lizard arm?
He's got, you know, he's not
yeah,
little tiny.
It goes all the way around like a lasso.
It's a seatbelt.
You're going to die, but it's a seatbelt.
Say that now. It takes over your brain. Like a few billion Arcanoids might, but you won't.
Hey, they need to go.
So, as they're heading back to us and we are
I didn't
walking.
Like it in the first place.
Hey, you guys are, I'm walking.
Yes, you know, indeed. It occurs to me that a year and a day, we kind of assumed that it meant a Terran year and a day.
No, I asked in our time, how long would we be here?
But I have an idea.
Yeah?
I think we can serve justice in this situation and maybe change Krypton for the better if I were to judge the judges.
You want to judge the judges?
I don't think it's going to work the way you think it's going to work, though. I think they'll just get mad. More
also,
mad.
Also, I think that once we're out of this...
And the judge hears that and says, why would you judge us?
Wait. Technically, there is a neutral way to judge anyone.
Yes, but we are on the side of right.
And if you're correct, if I were to judge you, you would feel nothing.
Why would that be?
Because. What is it that redeems someone, huh?
Action?
Depends on the person.
No, they redeem and then they have a new paradigm and then they take new action. What connects that bridge? What causes the new paradigm?
A decision to change.
The decision to change comes as a result of the new paradigm. The action flows from there. My point, I'm not trying to...
Break it down. Let's go on.
My point is simply that what causes the new paradigm is becoming aware of the suffering they have caused.
Oh. That assumes that they
were unaware of the suffering they were causing before, and they also give a crap.
Yeah, they may be aware of the suffering, but they're not empathetic to it, because they have not...
Oh, you mean awareness in, like, spiritual sense?
Sure.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you wish to show me here the suffering that has gone on within our construct, our prison, and you hope that it will change me for the better.
Empathy and sympathy.
I think if exposed to it, either you're right or I'm right, and that's only real way we can find out.
What kind of other prisoners are there here?
Many and varied, for a multitude of crimes.
To your point, though, can you
make a generalization about?
He just did.
Well, no, but I mean, is it like traffic violations, or are we talking crimes against all sentient beings?
Behold the power of epic condescension.
It is usually the conduct of sentient beings towards another sentient being. Be afraid.
Okay. And so they've committed crimes worse than ours?
Yes.
But this is all relative because their severity could be totally different than our severity. We don't know.
So we were sentenced to a year and a day for being party to the destruction of one.
That sentence, of course, split five ways.
So 5 years and 5 days, okay.
Yes.
So,
you just spit Dark Force into your hand.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And right. I'm charging it.
So what kind of,
I'm going to step away from the judge.
All right, so, what are some notable people we're likely to meet?
Destroy those who have destroyed worlds, other people, civilizations, brought empires to their knees, attempted to murder and have murdered many.
Well, that's not good. We can't let those guys out.
What body of law do you use to judge every other sentient species in the universe?
Kryptonian law.
So Kryptonian law makes you judge, jury, and executioner of every other sentient being in the universe?
It did until the collapse.
What collapse? The Kryptonian collapse? So what you're saying is you actually have no...
Our planet of Krypton was destroyed.
Yeah. And rightfully so.
Rightfully so?
Yeah. You guys just go around judging other people? Making them...
This is
we were at one point
subjugate to your laws and your whims.
We at one point were the seat of a galactic empire that was beginning to rival a larger empire that decided to take that seat and destroy it.
The Arkanoids.
Yes.
We've had a run-in with them.
How so?
Well, seeing as Terra is part of the Arkanoid Dominion, you really have no authority whatsoever.
I don't think that...
How is Terra a part of the Arkanoid Dominion?
They forced us to submit.
Forced you to submit?
Their technology was superior. That, or we would have been eradicated?
Yeah, I think so.
Then you, of course, don't submit to them.
We don't want to.
Then you are not part of their alliance and thus fall under Kryptonian jurisdiction.
No, we submitted.
No, we submitted.
Because we did not wish destruction.
Because there were no other options.
However, Tomahawk flies up and hears, "No, no, we submitted to the Arkanoids because there was no." And he goes, "Because there were no other options."
And the lizard's on my.
And there's a little. There's a lizard guy.
Nice. Hey, what's that?
Who's this?
He just called you a what? You can respond.
He is obviously a lower life form.
Well, he's like a half deity, so not really. He's just
a half deity.
Yeah.
And the lizard looks at you. What does he mean by half deity?
Just what he meant. Just what he said.
Half of what deity?
No deities that you know of. The Terran deity.
How do you know that I don't know the deities of which you speak?
Do you know...
Now you think I'm unintelligent?
Do you know anything about where I come from?
Where do you... That's what I'm asking
you. Terran, as you said.
He is slow,
isn't
he?
Oh, my God. Terran, whatever. Earth. That's where we come from.
Terran.
Yes.
So what deity do you worship there that you are beget from?
I don't worship any deities.
So he is not half deity.
He just doesn't worship his dad.
So who is his father?
Darth Vader?
No.
I don't know that.
Yeah, who is?
No one that you would know of.
I think you might have a brain thing going on.
Okay, so I don't
my know. My reason of 40 might agree with you.
No one that I know of, but who might that name be?
40 according to what metric?
Inches. Inches. Oh.
Yes. No, my father, his name is out of character, is it Fenrir.
Fenrir.
He's got these big-ass horns, all
Wait,
red.
Fenrir the wolf. that bit off Odin Allfather's hand.
Five gold stars here.
And is chained up in the... Oh,
it's a revelation of Ragnarok. Yeah,
yeah. Bring on Ragnarok.
You never asked.
And the lizard goes, "Oh, an Asgardian. Well, you should have said that from the beginning, deities.
What are you?" So that's the little lizard man.
I am Morat.
Yeah,
I told you. I told you there is no magic. There's only technology we don't understand. I told you.
Whee!
And you are not deity or. Demi deity.
No.
What do you want to do with this judge?
Oh, if someone says, if someone
asks, oh, and he goes, "What do you want to do with this judge?" And that's the first time the lizard notices the guy in full plate armor and goes, "A judge! Yeah, kill it! Kill it!"
I tell you, the judge is here.
And he hides behind Marty's skull head and peeks his little lizard beak up over the top and goes, "Kill it now!"
Well, judge, a challenge for you. If you think you truly are on the side of right, then I can do nothing to you. But, if I am right and you are wrong, you will feel the unjustified suffering you have caused.
When the judge looks at you, that makes absolutely no sense. He's probably punched me in the face, and it would go along with the commiserate feelings of being punched in the face.
Do you submit
does
to the test?
Does that make you right, or does that make me wrong?
Do you submit to the test, or are you scared?
What test?
The test.
There is no the test.
Are we we're arguing about pronouns? Is that what we're doing here?
No, we're saying you've come up with some probably logically flawed rationale.
You know what?
For why it is.
I say we subject this guy to some good old Terran justice and show him that might makes right. And we eat his head off of his body.
Might does not make right.
Ah, Arcanide to the end. You submitted to a worthy galactic empire. If might makes right, and that is the rule.
Well, you don't know, broken planet boy.
But we do not. Well, we do not hold to the Arcanoid's values.
No, Machiavellian.
Our planet wants to be independent.
He has tendencies. That's Nina speak for.
Oh, I'm gonna destroy you.
Many have tried. I suggest, in your vernacular, that you get some drinks and bring some friends.
So, are we going to kill this guy, or are we going to bring him with us, or...
Nah, he's useless.
Well, let's just let him go, then. Who cares? He's stuck here, too.
I'm going to try it. So, wait.
I'm going to try it.
How did they get out before?
Okay, we were told that there have
I'm
been
I'm attempting
escapes.
To use my judgment power.
There have been escapes
On
before.
The judge.
Oh, okay. All right.
Can you make me lucky? I've never tried this before, and I want to make sure it goes right.
Sure, why not?
I feel lucky.
I got a one.
Actually, no, I can't.
If we let you go, will you do harm to us, or will you be civil?
I'll give it a shot.
You are serving your punishment. What harm would I do to you?
Well, that's a green. I don't know, honestly.
Okay, what are you doing to him?
The judgment power. I'm
yes,
going to
what,
say...
What are you physically doing to him?
Have you... As you have rendered, so shall so what was the phrase?
As
Scott?
You have rendered, so shall you.
As you have judged, so shall you be judged.
That's that. Yeah. And then, touching him like the
he says, Wells goes, as you have judged, so shall ye be judged, and slaps his hand right on the judge's forehead.
Boom.
His head explodes.
Ooh.
In party.
Did he roll 100?
No, that was an 09.
He rolled a
9.
It's less than green.
Yeah. And he shakes for a moment visibly pales, begins to sweat, and then his eyes roll back in
and
his
head. I walk away. I don't even look at him. I'm just walking
and
away.
He, boom, just flat like a board, just drops to the ground.
Yeah.
I will move over and examine him to see what's wrong.
Do you have first aid?
I do.
No, I do not.
I'll go and do first aid on a being that I know nothing about.
Okay, well, you don't have to do first aid to just see if he's alive.
All right, yeah, first aid to...
Okay. He is alive.
No, he's still kicking.
He has been imprisoned for eternity times, however many, you know...
Is he conscious or he's...
Nope.
Out.
Right. He is out.
Well, let's just leave him. All
right, so how did they get out?
There were three who escaped when there was a massive explosion on the outside of the shape that grabbed us. And there were two more who made some kind of pact with a terrible evil creature called the Dread.
Dread. And Tomahawk, quick question. So you trust this lizard thing?
Morat!
Yeah, him too.
Morat is your friend?
He's a prisoner here.
So where's Morat looking? He's right here, right?
No, he's behind your... He's looking up over your head. Literally, like...
Yeah.
He's using your face as a shield.
So, I go... When you ask me if I trust him, I shake my head. Yes, and go...
Okay.
What is your crime, Morat?
Are you one of the ones who murdered thousands of people?
No.
More than thousands of people?
Why is my crime important?
Millions of people?
And you see his little hand.
You're ignoring the important question. You always ignore the important question. Did you have a good reason?
And his head pops up. I like you. Yes, I had a very good reason.
And what was that reason?
Because I wanted them dead.
Billions? Billions.
Go higher.
Trillions.
Yeah, around there.
Why did you want them dead?
They annoyed me.
He said
they were beneath me. They were specks that needed to be wiped out. They were in my way.
Well, that bad.
I don't...
Yes.
Sometimes...
And I agree. And you know what? The Arcanide Empire, what do you think about them?
They're detestable. They should be destroyed. I should turn my sights on them. But of course, I'd get caught and sent back here, so I really can't do that. And then I have to serve out a sentence here before I can even begin to make plans to do that. So
we bust you out again.
Yes, and this gentleman here, this Tomahawk, and he pats Tomahawk on the head, has said that he shall free me, that your group will assist in breaking us out.
Why are we planning to do genocide to the Arcanoids?
Arcanoids?
Whatever, them too. Yeah.
I mean, they are. What are you talking about?
That still doesn't dissuade what I said.
They haven't actually harmed us.
Why would we commit genocide against them?
Why would we commit genocide? Oh, no. We wouldn't do anything. But we would know somebody who can sever their connection. In other words, they lose their...
Why would we directly be a part of the genocide of an entire race?
Why, thank you.
Yeah, that's terrible.
Can I get some photos?
Do you mind
because
if we get rid of the Arcanides, they will no longer control our planet.
Can you make some of the metric? Yeah, just...
And he releases your neck and straighten his arm out. His arm goes about the length of his body, and it opens and compartmentalizes, and there's like way more on the inside than there should be.
I'm on rapid fire camera.
I'm
going to
communicate with the cybernetics.
Okay.
Like, jump in there and see what it's like on.
It's huge. And it's conscious. And yeah. You jump in and it goes, yes.
Oh, hello.
Yes.
Who are you talking to?
No, I'm...
He's going...
I'm just talking to my head.
Modem noises.
Oh, hello.
You've got mail.
Are you Morat?
Yes.
You are Morat?
Yes.
Okay. So I talked to Morat.
It's like freaking Ultron.
Oh, you are speaking with my prosthetic.
Yeah, I was just curious.
Yes?
You could hear that?
Yes.
Oh, cool. So I can talk to you through my mind then?
Well, you could talk to my prosthetic.
Neat. So, What kind of stuff can you do with that?
Oh, all sorts of things.
Destroy civilization.
Like genetic what? Recoding.
Really?
Aerosolization of viri. Oh, it's a wonderfully good tool.
Can you show us some of this stuff?
Why would I want to do that? Trade secrets, you know.
Oh, well, I don't know. I'm just curious.
The world is so lucky I'm not hearing this conversation.
Oh, no, this is out loud.
What?
This part, when he goes, you can hear this? Oh, yes, you spoke with my prosthetic. From there on, this has all been verbal between Morat and Tomahawk.
Yeah.
He's like, can you teach us this? Oh, I can do aerolization of viri, genetic manipulation. And he's like, oh, well, why would I want to share that? Trade secrets, you know.
Whoa. Hey, hi. Hello.
Hey, hi.
Do you have data sharing?
He's like, of course. You wouldn't want that.
Are we sure? We're the ones that need to leave.
You don't want that.
Us to share data.
Why?
Well, you're Dark Force.
Because he wants your data.
And I'm not.
Yeah.
And...
Yeah.
And you've got a firewire port, and that's just gross.
Hey.
What is that stuff encrusted all around that port?
Oh.
Hey, don't we need to go find this dread thing?
The dread.
Do you know anything about the dread?
I wouldn't.
This seemed...
That's what the judge said.
I think we should have exhaust every other possibility before seeking out something that awful.
Well, what about that explosion idea?
If we break this reality... We free the dread, right?
And probably everything else in here.
More worried about
that. Or it could just heal itself up like it did when we were earlier. And it's starting to fix itself. It's likely that it has self-regeneration.
But it sounds like Pandora's box. If we break this paradigm, if we break this box, we're screwed. The universe is screwed.
And Morat pipes up, yes, you don't want to release the dread.
Tell me what you know about that.
Oh, it devours everything that it touches.
No, it's not good.
Is it self-aware?
Oh, yes.
We have to make a deal with it, huh?
And I'm assuming...
We don't have to.
If we want to get out. That is true. A year and a day.
Nothing like that is going to help anyone else leave unless it furthers its own escape.
Oh, the dread cannot escape.
We could...
It can't escape, or it won't escape.
It could be...
Yes?
No. I hate doing that. I sincerely hate doing that.
Where is the dread from here?
Well, the dread is in... Do you want to know where the dread is? Are you sure?
I'm not sure, but yes, I'd like to know.
And that'll do us tonight for Gaming with Scott. We will talk to you real soon. Thanks for listening.
Dun, dun, dun.
That's it tonight for us on the Gaming with Scott podcast. You can always send us an email at gamingwscott@gmail.com or catch us on Twitter. Josh Elliott is at Asmodee369. John is at JPMGarlic. Josh Jackson is at ActionJack853. Rico is at R1C0. Or me, Scott T, at GamingWScott. You can also find us on Facebook at facebook.com/GamingWScott. Don't forget to check out nerdsdom.com for all their reviews and other great podcasts. Remember, be the superhero you always wanted to see in the world. As always, you'll be hearing from us real soon.